Well, good morning and welcome to day six as we continue our journey of reflections on the victory of the cross. And this morning we're going to look at the joy of salvation. You know, the joy of salvation is a profound and enduring aspect of our Christian experience. It's rooted in the transformative event of the cross. And this joy is not a fleeting emotion, but a deep-seated assurance that comes from knowing we are reconciled with God, forgiven, and destined for eternal life with Him. It transcends circumstances and remaining steadfast through trials and suffering, because it's based on the unchangeable truth of what Jesus accomplished on the cross. And this joy stems from the peace of knowing our sins are forgiven and that we are no longer under condemnation, but are now in a relationship with God as His children. It also comes from the hope of eternal life, the promise of God's presence and guidance in this life, and the ongoing work of the Holy Spirit within us, shaping us to be more like Christ. And this assurance of salvation through the cross brings joy into our daily lives, even amidst the suffering, by shifting our perspective from our present troubles to the eternal hope we have in Christ. And this hope assures us that our suffering is not meaningless, but is being used by God for our good and His glory. And it reminds us that in Christ, our trials can produce perseverance, character, and hope, which will not disappoint us because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit. And as we reflect on a recent trial or suffering and consider how assurance of salvation can transform our perspective on this situation, how does knowing the ultimate victory and eternal life promised to you in Christ gives you joy and peace in the midst of this difficulty? And then write down these reflections as a reminder of the joy of our salvation, especially on the challenging days. One of the natural responses to experiencing the joy of salvation is the desire to share the good news with others. This action not only obeys Jesus' command to make disciples, but also allows others to experience the same joy and peace we have found in Christ. So just think of someone in your life who doesn't know Jesus or the joy of salvation found in Him, and start to pray for an opportunity and the right words to share your salvation story with them. Consider writing down your testimony, focusing on the difference that Jesus has made in your life, and share it, either in conversation or through a letter or a message. But be open and honest about your own struggles and how the assurance of salvation has brought joy and peace into your life, inviting them to discover this joy for themselves. And this joy of salvation is a powerful and enduring aspect of our Christian life. It is providing peace and hope that sustains us through every season. And this joy is rooted in the accomplishments of the cross. It's meant to be cherished, nurtured through reflection and gratitude, and shared with those around us. By doing so, we are not only reinforcing our own faith, but also extending the invitation for others to experience the transformative joy of knowing Jesus as Saviour. So as we come to draw to an end to this day, we can now know that actually there's joy in knowing Jesus, and the power of the cross has reaffirmed that into our daily lives. So until tomorrow, I look forward to sharing with you then.